From Chaitanya Charitamrita, Madhya Leela, chapter 19, verse number 183 and 184. These are some of the most beautiful verses. Bhakta Bhede Rati Bheda Pancha Prakar. Shantarati Dasyarati Sakhyarati Yar
Shantarati Dasyarati Sakhyarati Yar
Vatsalyarati Madhurarati Ehi Panch Vibhed
Vatsalyarati Madhurarati Ehi Panch Vibhed
Rati Bhede Krishna Bhakti Rase Panch Bhed Bhakta Bhede Rati Bhede Pancha Prakar Shantarati Dasyarati Sakhyarati Yar Vatsalyarati Madhurarati Ehi Pancha Vibhed Rati Bhede Krishna Bhakti Rase Pancha Bhed Bhakta Bhede Rati Bhede Pancha Prakar शांतरति दास्यरति सख्यरति यार वात्सल्यरति मधुररति यही पंच विभेद व्रति भेदे कृष्ण भक्ति रसे पंच भेद. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace Srila A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada Ki Jai. Translation. According to the devotee, attachment falls within the five categories of Shantarati, Dasyarati, Sakhyarati, Vatsalyarati and Madhurarati. These five categories arises from the devotee's different attachments to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. The transcendental mellows derived from devotional service are also of five varieties. Purport. Shantarati is described in the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu as follows. Manase nirvikalpatvam shamaiti abhidhiyate. When one is completely free from all doubts and material attachments, he attains the neutral position called Shanta. Vihaya vishwon mukhyam nijananda sthitiryata atmanah katyate sotra svabhava shamityasau prayah samapradhananam mamata gandhavarjita paramatmataya krishne jata shanta ratirmata. The Shantarati realization of Krishna is in the neutral stage between the conception of impersonalism and personalism. This means that one is not very strongly attached to the personal feature of the Lord. An appreciation of the greatness of the Lord is called Shantarati. This is attachment not to the personal feature but to the impersonal feature. Generally, one in this stage is attached to the Paramatma feature of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Ishvarah sarvabhutanam hridideshair janatishtati brahmayan sarvabhutani yantrarudhani mayaya. The Supreme Lord is situated in everyone's heart, O Arjuna, and is directing the wanderings of all living entities who are seated as on a machine made of the material energy. On the strength of this statement from the Bhagavad Gita, we can understand that in Shantarasa, a devotee sees the Lord's representation everywhere. Dasyarati is explained in the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu thus. Swasmad bhavanti yenyunas tenukhraya harer matha aradhyatvatmika tesham rati pritir itirita. When the Supreme Lord is in his localized aspect, is appreciated and a great devotee understands his subordinate position, not only does he surrender to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, but due to his subordinate position, he wishes to render some service and thus become favored by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. A devotee in Shantarati is not very much willing to render service to the Lord. But a devotee in Dasyarati voluntarily wants to render service. Due to this attitude, the devotee in Dasyarati realizes the Supreme Personality of Godhead more fully than a devotee in Shantarati. He considers the Lord to be a worshipable object, and this means that his attachment for the Lord increases. Thus, Dasyarati is characterized as Bhaktihi Parishanubhavo Viraktir Anyatracha. In other words, on the Dasyarati platform, a devotee is attached to rendering service to the Lord and he is detached from material activities. Shantarati is neither material nor spiritual, but Dasyarati is actually on the spiritual platform. There is no attachment for material things on the spiritual platform. Viraktir anyatracha. A devotee in Dasyarati has no attachment for anything but Krishna's service. Sakhyarati is described in the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu as follows. Yesyu stulya mukundasya te sakhya satam mata samyad vishramba rupaisham rati sakhyam ihochate. According to the opinion of advanced devotees and learned scholars, a devotee in Sakhyarati feels equal to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is a relationship and friendship. Due to having a friendly relationship with the Lord, not only is one free from material attachment, but one believes in equal dealings with the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is called Sakhyarati. The Sakhyarati devotee is so advanced that he treats the Lord on an equal level and even exchanges joking words with him. Although one is never equal to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, the Sakhyarati devotee feels equal to the Lord, and he does not feel guilty because of this. Usually it is offensive to consider oneself equal to the Lord. The Mayavadis, for example, consider themselves equal to the Lord, but such feelings entail bereavement because they are material. Sakhyarati, however, is a feeling experienced in the mind by a pure devotee, and he is eternally related with the Supreme Personality of Godhead in that feeling. Vatsalyarati is described as follows in the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Guravo ye hare rasya te pujya iti vishruta anugraha mai tesham ratir vatsalyam uchyate idam lalana bhavyashish chibukha sparshanadikrit. When a living entity is situated on the platform of Vatsalyarati, he thinks of the Supreme Personality of Godhead in his childhood feature. In this feature, the Lord has to be protected by the devotee. And at this time, the devotee takes the position of being worshipped by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. These feelings of parental love are called Vatsalyarati. When the devotee is situated on this platform, he wants to maintain the Lord like a son, and he desires all good fortune for the Lord. He offers blessings to the Lord by touching his feet and head. Madhurarati, or attachment in conjugal love, is described as follows. Mitho harer mrugakshayash. Mitho harer mrugakshayascha sambhogasyadikaranam madhurapara paryaya priyatakhyo ditarathi asyam kataksha brukshepa priyavani smitadayah. Madhurarati, the conjugal relationship experienced between the Supreme Personality of Godhead and the young damsels of Vrajabhumi, continuously exists in eight kinds of remembrances. This intimate relationship brought about by conjugal love produces movements of the eyebrows, glancing, sweet words, and exchanges of joking words. A very beautiful purport. Omajnantaminandasya jnananjana shalakaya chakshurun milatam yena tasmai shri gurave namah. Namo om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Shrimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminiti Namine Namaste Saraswati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschatya Desha Tharine Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare. Very technical topic, very scientific topic. This verse deals with the different types of rati that are in existence in the spiritual world. There are two verses before this which have no purport, but I would like to read them out and just very briefly touch on them as well. Text number 181 says, Sattvika vyabhichari bhavera milana Krishna Bhakti Rasahaya Amritaswadana. When the higher standard of ecstatic love is mixed with the symptoms of sattvika and vyabhichari, the devotee relishes the transcendental bliss of loving Krishna in a variety of nectarian tastes. Vyaiche dadhisita grito maricha karpura milane rasala hoya amrita madhura. These tastes are like combination of yogurt, sugar candy, ghee, clarified butter, black pepper and camphor and are as palatable as sweet nectar. So the previous two verses are continuation from the verse before that, verse number 180, which is already discussed, which was Eishaba Krishna Bhakti Rasera Sthyayi Bhava Sthyayi Bhave Mile Jadi Vibhava Anubhava. All these stages combined are called Sthayi Bhava, or continuous love of Godhead in devotional service. In addition to these stages, there are Vibhava and Anubhava. So 180, 181, 182 talks about the rasa samagri. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says rasa samagri means the ingredients of rasa. And how many ingredients are there to taste rasa?
Five.
There are five ingredients. What are those five ingredients? Vibhava, Anubhava, Sattvika Bhava, Vyabhichari Bhava and Sthyayi Bhava. And what is the meaning of each one of these? Yes, so this subject is already dealt with by previous speakers, so I won't dwell on it too much. But the verses that are assigned to me, I will just summarize a little bit those verses, especially verse number 182. So basically rasa samagri, the ingredients of rasa are vibhava, anubhava, Sattvika Bhava, Vyabhichari Bhava and Sthyayi Bhava. Vibhava means the cause of experiencing Rati or ecstasy or bliss. What is the cause? So Vibhava means the Lord and his devotees. They need to be there for the ecstasy to be experienced. So Vibhava means the Lord and his devotee, the Ashraya Tattva and the Vishaya Tattva. Now when the Lord and his devotee, they meet, there are certain experiences, there is a feeling of affection, and that feeling of affection is expressed. Say a Sakha meets the Lord, the Sakha expresses the feeling of affection for the Lord by going, running towards the Lord and embracing him. This is Anubhava, the expression of ecstasy voluntarily. But as he embraces the Lord, sometimes in certain situations, or let's say Mother Yashoda, when she saw the Lord dancing on the hoods of the Kaliya, she was stunned. This stunning, the feeling of being stunned, is a experience of Sattvika Bhava. Pralaya is one of the Ashta Sattvika Vikara. So Yashodamayi was stunned and she fainted. That fainting is a sattvika. It is born of affection, it is born of rati. However, sattvika vikara is involuntary, anubhava is voluntary. So voluntarily the sakhas would approach the Lord and play with the Lord, lift the Lord on their shoulder or embrace him. But sattvika bhava is involuntary, it is uncontrolled, like Yashodamai is fainting. And then there is vyabhichari bhava. Vyabhichari bhava is a intense emotion which arises out of affection. Again, when Yashodamai saw Krishna crawling on Putana, just out of intense affection, she felt very, very scared. Maybe this demoness is going to kill my child. So she was, that feeling of being scared was born of affection for the Lord. And so that is the vyabhichari bhava. It's an intense affection. It is intense. It arises and it subsides. So these five together is what gives, these five ratis together is what gives experience of rasa. And these are compared very beautifully by Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, and here by the words of Lord Chaitanya, as yogurt which is mixed with sugar candy, ghee, black pepper and camphor. Yogurt represents the sthyayi bhava. Sugar candy represents the vibhava. Ghee represents the anubhava. Black pepper represents sattvika bhava. And camphor represents vyabhichari bhava. So, those are the comparisons being made. There's no purport to that verse, but those are the comparisons which are being made. So I'll move on from that topic to a topic which is dealt with in the following verse. There are five kinds of rati, which are mukhya rati, or principal ecstasies. And there are seven kinds of secondary ratis and gauna ratis, and those are dealt with in subsequent verses. This verse deals with the five kinds of ratis. What are the five kinds of ratis dealt with in this verse? Anyone? Shantarati, Dasyarati, Sakhyarati and Vatsalya and Madhurya. So these are the five ratis. Shantarati is experienced by two kinds of individuals. Those who are Atmaramas and those who are Tapasvi Yogis. The Shantarati is experienced by Atmaramas. And the example is given. Any example of Shantarati Bhaktas? I want to make it a little interactive, otherwise it will be a very difficult topic to get into. Sorry?
I heard
Krishna's flute is in Shantaras.
Krishna's flute
is in Shantaras. Is it? Shantarati is experienced. Yes, Shantarati is experience of indifference. The cause of Shantarati is Shama. Shama means indifference towards the external sense objects. It's not indifference to the Lord. It is indifference to the external sense objects. And that is the cause. So there are two kinds of individuals who experience Shantarati. The Atmaramas and the Tapasvis. Example of some Atmaramas? The four Kumaras. They were Atmaramas. And when they were Atmarams, thinking of themselves as, you know, one with the Lord, or even thinking of themselves as, you know, enjoyers in the Brahma Jyoti, they were Brahmanandis. Brahmanandis. So they, when they saw the Lord, when they smelled the tulsi which are offered to the lotus feet of the Lord, their heart was completely transformed and they experienced Shanta Rasa. This is mentioned in the third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, right? Okay. Any other examples of Atmaramas? Shukadeva Goswami, he was an Atmarama. When he heard Srimad Bhagavatam, he experienced initially Shanta Rasa. Amongst the yogis, there was once an assembly of yogis in the in the court of Brahma. And Brahmaji was explaining the different Upanishads from a Krishna conscious point of view. And when these yogis, they heard these explanations, their hearts transformed and they experienced Shanta Rasa. Another example is on the battlefield of Kurukshetra, when Krishna blew his conch shell, because Kurukshetra is Dharma Kshetra, there were several yogis who were residing at Kurukshetra and meditating, performing austerities. And when Krishna blew his Panchajanya conch shell, the yogis immediately came out of their meditative state. They were meditating on Paramatma in the heart, and they were drawn to the sound of the conch shell blew, which was blown by Lord Krishna, and they immediately experienced Shanta Rasa. So the yogis, they experience Shanta Rasa. These examples are given by Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu by Srila Rupa Goswami. So Shantarati is experienced. Shantarati is not Shantarasa. Shantarati is the Sthyayi Bhava, the underlying ecstasy that helps one experience Shantarasa. So Shantarati, two examples, Atmaramas and Tapasvinis. What about Dasyarati? Dasyarati examples. What is Dasyarati? What is the main characteristics of Dasyarati?
Awe and reverence.
Awe and reverence.
Serves.
To serve. Dasyarati, the main characteristics of Dasyarati is to serve. And there are four kinds of dasas. Krishna has four kinds of devotees who express this Dasyarati. Firstly, there are servants who have been appointed by him, appointed by the Lord. And these are the Adhikrita Das. Adhikrita Das means servants who are appointed. They are supposed to do certain things. The examples are the demigods, the devatas, especially the Upadevatas, the lesser demigods. The lesser demigods are, you know, Varuna and Agni. These are lesser demigods. They are appointed servants, so they are called Adhikrita Das. And then you have devotees of the Lord who seek their protection from the Lord. So these devotees, they serve the Lord and they seek protection from the Lord. These are second kind of Dasya Bhaktas. They are called Ashrita Das. Ashrita Das means those who have taken shelter of the Lord. Give me some examples of devotees who serve the Lord in the mood that they have taken shelter of the Lord. Any examples? Anant Shesh, no. Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj experienced Vatsalya. Haridas Thakur.
He was the
Namacharya. He was in Dasya Rasa. Haridas Thakur was, well, the Acharyas say he was in Madhurya Rati. He had a much higher. So Dasya example is Naimisharanya Rishis. The Rishis in Naimisharanya, they took shelter of Shaman Prabhu. You have anything to add? Yes, so where is Hanuman? We'll talk about Hanuman also. So, Ashrita Dasa, who has taken shelter, is Indra, who takes shelter of Lord Narayan. And he says, you please appear and protect me. So the Lord appears as Upendra, Vamana, because Indra took shelter. So Indra is considered to be Ashrita Das. The snake Kaliya is considered to be Ashrita Das, because he, after the Lord danced on his hood, the Lord, he seeked protection from the Lord. By the way, these examples are not mine. They are given in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu by Rupa Goswami himself. He himself gives these examples. And Lord Shiva is, he expresses Ashrita Das. He takes shelter, he seeks protection of the Lord. But a little bit higher flavor of this Dasyarati is personal servants who are known as Parishada Das. So Parishada Das are personal servants of the Lord. And these personal servants are in Dwarka as well as in amongst the Kurus. Amongst the Kuru dynasty also he has Parishada Dasa, and in Dwarka also he has Parishada Das. So in Dwarka, who are the personal servants of the Lord? Uddhava, very good. Uddhava, Satyaki. So when the Lord wants to discuss some military arrangements, he tells Satyaki, you get engaged. But he's close, you know, to the Lord. And Daruka. Daruka is also one of the servants, personal servants of the Lord in Dwarka. In Kurukshetra, or in amongst the Kurus rather, not Kurukshetra, amongst the Kurus, we have Parikshit, for example. Parikshit Maharaj. We have Bhishma. We have Vidura. They are all Parishada Das. They are very intimate servants. But they are personal servants more than intimate from the point of view of being able to understand the mind of the Lord. They are personal servants. They render personal service to the Lord. So if you see the previous examples, the Adhikrita Das, like the Agni, Vayu, they don't render personal service to the Lord. Similarly, those who seek protection, the Ashrita Das, they don't render personal service to the Lord. But this third category, Parishada Das, they render personal service to the Lord. But then there is a much deeper mood of Das, Dasya Bahu, which is Anuga Das. Anuga Das means servants of the Lord who always follow the Lord wherever the Lord goes. So if you think of Vidura, Bhishma, or Parikshit, they don't follow everywhere where the Lord goes. But these Anugas, they are always following the Lord. And we may have actually not heard of them. So I will give you the examples. In Dwarka, we have personal intimate servants who are always following the Lord. Example is Mandana, Suchandra, Sutamba, etc. Mandana is the name of his servant in Dwarka who is always carrying the umbrella on the head of the Lord, always. Wherever the Lord goes, he'll carry an umbrella. Suchandra is one who is always fanning the Lord with a white chamara. Sutamba is one who has got a box of betel nuts and he is offering the Lord. And he's always following the Lord in Dwarka. Similarly, in Yashodamai's house, in Vraja, you have different servants in Yashodamai's house. Like we have Bakula, Varika, Rasala. And these servants also perform intimate service for the Lord. So Bakula, for example, Yashodamai will tell him, "Oh, Krishna has come back from tending the cows. This is his dhoti, this is his top. Please wash it and make it very, very clean." So Bakula's duty, he's the one who washes the clothes of the Lord. That's his primary duty. Similarly, Rasala is one who helps cooking, and especially he makes nice betel nut for the Lord. And you have Varika. Varika, every morning he prepares the bathtub for Krishna. And he puts aguru and other incense and other flowers, different fragrances in the water for the Lord. So these are Parishada Dasas. Sorry, these are Anuga Dasas. Parishada Dasas are those who are personal servants, but these are Anuga. They are always follow. They are always very close. They are very intimate. So these are four kind of Dasa Rati. The Adhikrita Das, Ashrita Das, Parishada Das, and Anuga Das. And then Sakhyarati. Sakhyarati is primarily of two types. Vraja Sakha and Pura Vayasya. Pura Vayasya means friends in the town. And Vraja Sakha means friends in Vraja. Dasarati is expressed by these two. So Vraja Sakha, they cannot tolerate the separation from the Lord. And the Vraja Sakha themselves are of four categories in Vraja. They are Surits. Surit means well-wishers. They are friends, but they are well-wishers of the Lord. The example is given of older boys. They are generally older boys, older than Krishna. They want to protect Krishna. And they have slightly Vatsalya Bhava, because Vatsalya Bhava is to protect the Lord. So the example is Mandali Bhadra, Yaksha, and also Balabhadra. Lord Balram expresses Sakya Bhava with the Lord. And Surid Bhava. Surid Sakya means he is a well-wisher of the Lord. They want to protect the Lord. So for example, when the Lord lifted the Govardhan Hill, these Surid Sakhas, they got their different weapons. Somebody had a sword, somebody had a stick, and they were surrounding Krishna because they wanted to protect if some demon comes and wobbles the hill. So they wanted to protect the Lord. So then Krishna tells them, "Oh, Arishtasura is not going to come, don't worry. This is just me lifting the hill, so you don't need to worry." But they have this natural tendency to protect the Lord because they are older boys. But then there are boys who are younger to the Lord. They are called as Sakhas. For example, Devaprastha. He is always wanting to massage the feet of the Lord. He will always, you know, he will tuck Krishna's dhoti properly and he'll say, "You know, you now appear proper. He'll fix the dhoti. He'll put the crown for the Lord. But he's a friend, but he's a younger boy. So his natural mood is to serve the Lord. And then you have Priya Sakhas, who are confidential servants or confidential friends. And these are the same age as the Lord. And amongst the Priya Sakhas, you have Shridama, Sudama, Stoka Krishna. We know those names. We know what those, those devotees are. Priya Marma Sakha is the fourth category and the most intimate category of friendship. The Priya Marma Sakhas are Subala, Ujwala. We know about them as well, what they do and what are the pastimes. So I don't need to mention. So the second category is Pura Vayasya. Pura Vayasya means friends who are in the city. Who are these friends? They are Arjuna, Bhima, even Draupadi has a mood of friendship. Shridama and Madhumangala are in the Priyamarma Sakhas. Shridama is categorized in both Priya Sakha and Priyamarma Sakha. But mainly Yudhishthir, Bhima, Nakula and Sahadeva and Draupadi, they are the Sakhas in the Pura, in the towns. Again, they don't have clear, these Sakhas don't have clearly, so Yudhishthir Maharaj does not just express Sakhyaras, he also expresses Dasyaras. Similarly, Uddhava, he primarily expresses Dasyaras, but he also has an underlying Sakhyaras. Again, this is mentioned by Rupa Goswami in the Bhaktir Samrita Sindhu. And Vatsalya Ras, who are the examples for Vatsalya Ras? So Yashoda, Nanda, Rohini, Kunti Maharani is also in Vatsalya Ras. Even the cows in Vraja, they have Vatsalya Ras because they give their milk. Then the 15 wives of Vasudev also express Vatsalya Ras. Vasudev himself expresses Vatsalya Ras. But Ugrasen is the grandfather of Krishna. He does not express Vatsalya Ras alone. He expresses Vatsalya Ras along with Dasya Ras mixture. Because he, whenever he sees Krishna, he desires to embrace him and then serve him as a servant. So he expresses both. And Madhurya Ras is expressed by Srimati Radharani and the gopis of Vrindavan. And also in Dwarka you have Rukmini and others. So like that. So these are the five main ratis. So this verse says, according to the devotee's attachment, Bhakta Bhede Rati Bhede Pancha Prakar Shantarati Dasyarati Sakhyarati are Vatsalyarati Madhurarati Ei Panch Vibhed Rati Bhede Krishna Bhakti Rase Pancha Bhed Rati Bhede Krishna Bhakti Rase Pancha Bhed Rati Bhede, based on one's affection towards the Lord, these different ecstasies are experienced. Because the Lord is Akhila Rasamrita Murti. He is the embodiment of all rasas, of all mellows of ecstasies. Every relationship one can have with the Lord. And He is able to simultaneously express all of those different relationship simultaneously with different individuals. So the five primary rasas are Shantadasya, Sakhya, Vatsalya and Madhurya. And the seven Gauna rasas, anyone knows what those seven are? I think the following verses will talk about the seven Gauna rasas. The seven Gauna rasas are Hasya, which means laughter, Adbhuta, which means astonishment, Veera, which means heroism, Karuna, compassion, Raudra, anger, Bhayanaka, fear, And bibhatsa means disgust. So Bhishma, although he was in Dasya Ras as his Mukhya Ras, he had a Gauna Ras of Virya. So these seven Gauna and seven secondary and five primary rasas are constantly experienced by devotees based on their own affection for the Lord. Rati bhede Krishna bhakti rase pancha bhed. Rati bhede, based on the devotee's mood, his affection or her affection, they experience. And there is one very beautiful verse in Srimad Bhagavatam, 10th canto, chapter 43, verse number 17, which discusses the pastime of Krishna being invited by Kamsa to the wrestling arena. And when Krishna is invited by Kamsa to the wrestling arena, please listen carefully. He goes there along with Balaram, and as soon as he enters the wrestling arena, the description is given how different people who are sitting in the audience, what was, as well as the two mallas, malla meaning the wrestlers, the two wrestlers who are going to wrestle them, Chanura and Mushtika, what was the rasa that they were exchanging with Krishna. So each one of these different people in the audience had a different rasa. And I want you to listen carefully, and somebody can count how many rasas we cover. So there are five primary and seven secondary rasas. So the verse says, Mallanam Ashanir. So the mallas, the wrestlers, when they saw Krishna, they saw him as a thunderbolt. You know, when a thunderbolt strikes, there is no fighting back. Can you fight back the thunderbolt? No. You get, a thunderbolt strikes you, then you just, you know, it's one of the strongest things. So the mallas, the wrestlers, when they saw Krishna, what did they see? They saw him as thunderbolt, and that brought, that increased the mood of fighting with the Lord. That increased their mood. So that was Virya Ras. Next, Nrinam Naravaraha. Amongst the common people who were in the audience, they thought, Krishna looks like the best of men. So they were wondering, he looks amazing. So this wonderment is Adbhutarasa. Second, Adbhutarasa. Strinam Smaro Murtiman. Amongst the women who were watching, Smara Murti. Murti means form, Smara means Kamadev, the god of love. So these women, for them, Krishna was as if Kamadev personified. They had developed intense love for him. So they expressed the Madhurya Rati. So especially the women of Vrindavan who had come there to watch, they expressed Madhurya Rati. So third, Gopanam Swajano. Amongst the gopas, the cowherd friends, they thought of him as, oh, come on Krishna, you know, beat them up. So they were laughing because they were thinking, oh, look at these two big, you know, teddy bear like wrestlers. They're going to be, you know, they're just going to hug Krishna, and Krishna is just going to be hugging them for some time, and then he'll bash them up and he'll kill them. Like Krishna killed so many demons. So they were not scared. They were laughing. They were making jokes about Chanur and Mushtik. And they were thinking of Krishna as their own friend. Oh, come on, you are a friend of us. They were cheering up Krishna. So they express Sakhya Ras and Hasya Ras. Hasya is the secondary Ras. Asatam Kshiti Bhujam Shashta. Asatam Kshiti Bhujam. Then there were some kings who were invited. And those kings were demoniac kings. They were invited by Kamsa. When they saw Krishna, they felt angry towards Krishna. Raudra Rasa, which is the secondary rasa, anger. Swapitro Shishuhu. Swapitro means all those family members like Krishna's father, mother, Nanda Maharaj, Yashoda Mai, when they were seated there in the audience, and all the senior gopas and gopis, when they were seated in the audience, they were thinking of Krishna as Shishuhu. Shishuhu means our dear unprotected child. We need to protect him. So they expressed Vatsalya Rasa. So you see, Krishna is in the wrestling arena, the same personality, and all of these other personalities having the different mood based on their own affection of the Lord. Mrityur Bhojapate. Bhojapati means Kamsa. He saw Krishna as Mrityu, death personified. Here is death on the wrestling arena. For him, Krishna was non-different from death, and because it was death, the greatest fear that a person has is death. And so he expressed the Bhayanaka Rasa. He experienced the Bhayanaka Rasa, which is fear. Virad Avidusham. Those who were fools in the audience, foolish people in the audience, they thought of Krishna as Virat, as somebody. They thought, oh, this is disgusting. Two little kids fighting with these well-known wrestlers. It's just disgusting. So they expressed disgust. So they expressed bibhatsa. And tatvam param yoginam. Some yogis had also gathered there, because Kamsa would take counsel from the rishis and the yogis. And these yogis, when they saw Krishna, they saw tatvam param. The supreme transcendental truth is standing in front of us. They express the Shantarasa. And Vrishninam Paradevaiti. All the Vrishnis, all the Yadus who had gathered there, the Vrishnis who had gathered there, they just thought, oh, he is the best of Kshatriyas, we should serve him. Krishna is the best of Kshatriyas. We should serve him. So they expressed the Dasya Ras. So how many Rasa in total?
They said 5 or 7.
How many Rasas in one verse? How many Rasas are there expressed in this one verse? All 12 Rasas. They are in this one verse of Srimad Bhagavatam. All 12 Rasas. Mallanam Ashanir. Drinam Naravaraha, Strinam Smaro Murtiman, Gopanam Swajano, Asatam Kshiti Bhujam Shashta Swapitro Shishu, Mrityur Bhojapater Virada Vidusham, Tatvam Param Yoginam, and Vrishninam Paradeveti. So these are all the Mukhya Rathis and Gauna Rathis. Experience by the same, the personality is the same, the Vishaya is the same. Vishaya means the Lord is the same, but the Ashraya, the several devotees, they see the Lord and have a long exchange with the Lord based on their own ratis, based on their own individual moods. The same thing also happened when the Lord lifted Govardhan Hill. When he lifted Govardhan Hill, so the external reason for lifting Govardhan Hill obviously was to protect and give shelter to all the devotees. But the internal reason was to be close to the to all the different gopas, cows, you know, every different kind of bhakta would be together with the Lord simultaneously, which is not otherwise possible. And hence, this is mentioned by Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur in the 10th canto. So this verse, Srila Prabhupada has explained what I just explained through those verses of Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. They're extremely technical, and we can understand through these examples of the names of devotees that we mentioned what these five primary rasas are. The next speakers will speak about the seven gauna rasas, and this is how the conversation between Lord Chaitanya and Rupa Goswami will carry on. And almost after 30 years of this conversation, Rupa Goswami wrote the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, in which he consolidated all of these verses that are being mentioned in Chaitanya Charitamrita. He consolidated and gave a systematic presentation, a scientific presentation. I call it scientific because science means a premise and then there is an evidence. If we read Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, it is similar. There is a premise, there is a definition, and then he gives evidence from the scriptures of various bhaktas who have experienced those different moods. So it is completely scientific. As Srila Prabhupada subtitled Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, the Nectar of Devotion, as the complete science of Bhakti Yoga. Prabhupada says the complete science of Bhakti Yoga. So it's a very scientific subject matter. It is not a sentimental subject matter. And it should be dealt with, approached, and understood in a scientific way. And then we will be able to imbibe it, you know, the process of devotional service in our lives. So with this, I will stop here. Does anyone have any questions? Anyone? Yes.
So which rasa is Hanumanji?
Which rasa is Hanumanji? He is Parishada Dasya Rasa. He is Dasya Rasa, but even in the Dasya, he is Parishada, which means he personally serves the Lord as the Lord directs him to do. Any other questions, comments, corrections? Yes. Yeah, how do we use this understanding in real life? So the scriptures, they mention three things. They mention about three topics: sambandha, abhideya, and prayojana. The topic we are currently dealing with is prayojana, is the goal. You know, if you want to drive from here to, say, Edinburgh, you need to have three things. What are the three things? You need to have a car, you need to probably have a map, yeah? And then you need to know that Edinburgh exists and this is what it is and this is why I need to be there. So that knowledge of Edinburgh has to be there. The knowledge of how to drive has to be there, and the car has to be there. And the map has to be there. Similarly, sambandha tattva. So the scriptures sometimes, some areas of the scripture deal with sambandha, which talk about identifying our relationship with the Lord. So it's very instructive. And some parts of the scripture speak about abhidaya. How do you practically apply? So where we have the nine steps of devotional service, starting from Shraddha, reaching up to prema, bhava and prema. These nine steps is how we practically apply. This is abhideya. This is how one practically, this is the map. But what verses we are currently dealing with is the prayojana, is the goal. So we know that this is our goal. We know that there are these wonderful exchanges between devotees and the Lord, and they exist. So what is the point reading this? So there's only one and only one reason why one reads prayojana. The one reason is Preeti Vardhanartham, to develop that loving greed of achieving that ultimate goal. When one knows the goal, without knowing the goal, one will not be able to understand how to tread on the path. Correct? So these verses, currently the verses that we are discussing, these verses are very technical in nature, but nonetheless they should be understood to whatever capacity we can understand. Anyway, the end of Chaitanya Charitamrita, Antyalila, chapter 20, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he says, Lord Chaitanya's glories and his pastimes and his instructions and his message is like the limitless sky. So a bird can fly in a limitless sky. How can I describe the limitless sky? I cannot describe it, Kaviraj Goswami is saying. But then he's saying, but we as bhaktas can fly in that sky as high as we can based on our capacity. So we should read Srila Prabhupada's books. He's made this subject matter so accessible for all of us. And we should understand what that prayojana is. We should follow the abhideya and we should build the sambandha. And that will give us perfection, siddhi. So, but it is always the case, even Srimad Bhagavatam, first canto, chapter one, Suta Goswami says, I will now tell you what I've heard based on my understanding. Yatha dhitam yatha matihi. Based on my understanding and what I've heard. So ultimately, devotees will only be, everyone will have their limitations. But there is no exclusion still. We should still continue to read. So this particular subject matter, how does it practically apply to us? We understand what the goal is. We understand ultimately what the rasas are. Yeah. Okay. Does that make sense, Prabhu? Okay. Thank you. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Samaveda Bhakta Vrinda ki jai. There might be a few announcements. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Thank you, Kartik Chandra Prabhu. Very wonderful. I was quite astonished. Very wonderful. Thank you, Hare Krishna. Okay, we have some Sankita results to read. Okay, yesterday there are three scores. So three devotees were out on the street. So starting with Bhakta Dimitri, 15 Lakshmi points, 10 medium books, 1 Maha big book, for a total of 7 book points. Haribo. Bhakta Vayu, 72 Lakshmi points, 29 medium, 1 big and 1 and 8 Maha big, 31.5 book points. Haribo. And Bhakta Rajesh, 206 Lakshmi points. 2 small books, 115 medium, 3 big, 14 Maha Big for a total of 89 book points. Arigo! Okay, yesterday in our Radha's boutique, we distributed 7 books and collected total of 260 Lakshmi points. Haribo! Closet Krishna Rochester, 4 medium, 4 small books, and total collection 124 Lakshmi points. And yesterday in Govinda's restaurant, we distributed prasadam for at least 272 paid customers for a total of 2057.64 Lakshmi points. Arigo! Now we just want to ask who would love to help on ladies' side to serve prasadam. Thank you. On the men's side? Okay, I can help as well. Thank you. And we need few volunteers to clean the temple afterwards. Preferably someone who doesn't go for Sankirtan straight away. Okay, no one. Okay, thank you very much. Thank you, Ruhu. Okay, Hare Krishna. So just please now, first we say the prayer to their lordships. Dear Sri Sri Radha Londonishvara, Jagannath Baladev and Subhadra, Sri Sri Gonitai and Giri Govardhan, we offer our most respectful obeisances unto you. In a mood of deep gratitude and appreciation, we request your causeless mercy upon us. For your pleasure, if you so desire, we wish to erect a holy place of your transcendental pastimes that will attract unlimited souls to your service and fulfill the vision of your pure devotee Srila Prabhupada for London. Please enable us to cooperate together in order to satisfy you in this way. We, your surrendered servants, humbly beg. New temple for Radha Londonishvara ki jai. Shri Shri Radha Londonishvara Jagannath Baladev Subhadra Gornitai Giri Govardhan ki jai. Prasadam chain ki. Thank you.